All right. Okay, we have started.
All right. Welcome to this interview, right, between me and Alaric, right? So I'm very excited to have Alaric right here on board. So if y'all didn't know, right, Alaric is a young guy. He's a freaking action taker. He's what I really call a master implementer, right? So Alaric right now, like his business in the past 16 months, right, has actually generated more than $1 million worth of revenue, right? He has actually trained more than 1,000 students, right? And at the same time, right, like, he has already done and launched about 5 businesses already, right, Ellery?
Correct. Yeah, so like,
since you're 19, right? So I think like his achievements is something not to be laughed at, right? Something that is really amazing. Some people what wish they could achieve in a lifetime, right? So Ellery, right, could you just welcome and could you just introduce a bit about yourself, your experience, and what we could, like, and that's how we get started.
Okay, so I just do a very quick intro because I want this video to be about giving value rather than about me, okay? But basically, I've done 5 different businesses before. Most of the businesses, I started with zero capital. So for example, like my coaching business, it started with zero capital. Like, okay, I've done 5 different businesses. The 3rd, 4th, and 5th business, I didn't start with any capital, okay? And I turned them into 6-figure and 7-figure businesses very, very quickly. So I always believe that you don't need money to make money. So maybe that could be the first lesson that we write down. You don't need money to make money, right? What you need to make money are ideas, skill sets to make money. The more skill sets you have, the more money you make. Yeah. So, for example, recently, yesterday, I bought over a business. I bought 20% of a business for $1. Okay. Okay. I bought 20% of a business for $1. Okay. I just share with you about business I did last week. Okay. So last week, right, I bought a tuition business, 20% of a tuition business for $1. On Saturday, last Saturday, I bought 20% of a business for $1. Okay. On Sunday, I sold 1% for $6,000. Okay? On Monday, I also sold 1% for $6,000. Which means, if 1% is worth $6,000, 20% is worth how much? $120,000. That means my net worth, right, in 3 days, right, grew by $120,000 in 3 days. Make sense?
Wow, yeah.
Right? Okay, so this proves that, okay, number one, making money is a formula, right? Making money, okay, like after a while, after you make money, right? Okay, if you make money from working a job and you exchange time for money, you think that, hey, making money is about making money like that. But when you go into different markets, right? And when you start doing business, you start doing other stuff, right? You start realizing that money doesn't even exist. Like, a lot of people say, oh, I'm a multi-millionaire property investor. No, they borrow maybe $5 million to buy a property. They pay maybe $1 million down payment. Let's say, I put 100K as a down payment to buy a $3 million property. Okay, 300K as a down payment, whatever. To buy a $3 million property. Am I really a multi-millionaire property investor? Okay, I own multi-million dollars of assets, but I still owe the bank multi-million. So it counts asset liabilities for the same, right? So as I started exploring into the world of entrepreneurship more and more, I realized that the way the rich people play the game and the way employees and everything play the game is completely different. Yeah, it's completely different. Yeah. So okay, let me share with you how I bought the business for $1.
For sure, man. I think like people like know like how it did.
So okay, basically my value is this, okay. So because I've done my own successful coaching businesses before, and before the coronavirus, I was doing about $100,000 a month. After the coronavirus, honestly, my income dropped quite a bit. By about 80%, okay. But I mean, in terms of net, like in terms of like acquiring businesses and everything, I'm still acquiring businesses. But in terms of like my coaching business income, because I cannot do seminars anymore, it dropped quite a bit. But anyway, so because I've done successful businesses before, right? So I approach people. So let's say I can approach Mark. I say, hey Mark, right now you have a business, right? So let's say Mark runs a tuition business, okay? And maybe he's making, okay, let's just say a lady, okay? So I bought a business from a lady. She's making about 2.5K per month running her tuition business. She's doing one-to-one tuition, okay? Yep. And I told her, okay, how about this? Okay, so I told her you got two options, okay? The first option, right, is you continue making 2.5K per month for the rest of your life.
Yep.
The second option, right, is you partner with me, okay? You just give me 20%, you still get 80%, okay?
Yep.
But I feel I can help you grow your business. That's one. And number two, right? The moment you partner with me, right? The value of your business will rise. Why? I tell you like that. I say, okay, so right now you got this tuition business making 2.5K per month. You want to sell it, I think people won't even pay 10K for the whole business because there's no intellectual property, there's no assets, there's no value of the business. Okay? But now you say, okay, you partner with Alaric, okay? So they don't need to know how much your shares I own. Even I own 50% or 20%, doesn't matter, right? But your partner with Alaric, and Alaric is coaching her on how to run her tuition business. Yep. Now, with her, and I've done, I've for me, I can get like 100 clients a month easily, right? So I've done successful businesses before. So if I'm going to help her do marketing, do you think investors are more likely to invest in her business? Definitely,
for
right?
Sure, man.
So yeah, that's how I increase the value of the business to become, the whole business now becomes worth $600,000 because I was able to sell 1% of the business for $6,000, okay? Now, yep. But how do I pitch? So to her, to my tuition business, it makes sense for her to partner with me. True? Because she's giving up 20% of a 10K business to make to have 60% of a maybe 70% of a 600K business. True?
Yep.
Yes, right? Okay, that's one. Number two, so how did I get investors to pay $6,000 for 1%? I told them this. I say, okay, so she's making about $2,500 per month. That means she's making about $30,000 per year. $2,500 times 12 is about $30,000 per year. Make sense?
Yep.
Right. Okay. You can write notes or you can write some calculations if you want. So she's making $30,000 per year, right? Let's say they own 1% of the business, right? That means if they own 1% of the business, they will get $300 a year in dividends. 1% of what they make, right?
Okay.
So I told them this. I said, okay, if you pay $6,000 to own 1% of this company and you make $300 a year in dividends, that's about 5% dividend yield. Is that pretty good?
Yeah,
doing Buffer Online School, you do stocks, right? 5% dividend yield is about SCI is about maybe 4%, right?
Yeah.
You do BreadTalk, OSIM, Haidilao, 0.25% dividend yield. 5% is like 10 times better than Haidilao, true?
Yep.
Dividend yield, huh? Okay. I told them this. If let's say now Nisa makes $5,000 per month, okay, Nisa is the lady that if she makes $5,000 per month, she'll make $60,000 per year. If they own 1%, they'll make $600 a year. They invest $6,000 to make 10% dividend yield. Is that good?
Yeah.
That's good, right?
Good.
Okay. On top of that, at the point of time where she makes $5,000 per month, their shares will not be worth $6,000 anymore. It'll be worth $12,000 because the next investor won't mind paying $12,000 to make $600 a year in dividends. Make sense?
Yeah.
So to them, it's a good deal, right? And on top of that, I tell the investor this. I say, okay, number one, financially, you know it's a sound investment. Number two, when you invest $6,000, you can say that you're a partner with Alaric and Nisa, right?
Yeah.
And you can say that you're a shareholder in a six-figure business.
Mm.
Right? And then, so they get a branding of that. Number three, I say you get to learn behind the scenes of how we run a business. Which means if you go for a seminar, you spend $6,000 to go for a seminar. You might not know how to run a business, you know, but now you invest $6,000, we show you step by step how we run a business as a shareholder. Is that all not worth $6,000? That's worth $6,000, right? And I told them, on top of that, you're helping tuition kids and everything. Every kid that we help, you're helping this is good as charity, you know. Not charity, but
yeah.
So because of that, we pitched to three investors, all three investors paid $6,000. We had a 100% closing rate. We raised about $18,000. We raised $6,000 on Saturday, $6,000 on Sunday. And then on Friday, we raised another $6,000. Yeah. But after that, we're not looking for investors really because we don't need money. We got enough money. Yeah. But basically, my main point is this, okay? That money is not made. Money is not earned. Money is created.
Yep.
钱不是赚来的,钱是变出来的. Yeah. And the moment you have this paradigm shift, right? That money's created. How did I create $120,000 of value for me? I just created it like that, right? Make sense? But here's the thing. Did everyone win? Did the tuition teacher win?
Nope.
Yes, right? Because now from worth $10,000, now her business, now she has she has about 65% of shares in a $600,000 business. I increased her net worth to $360,000 straight away, like that, right?
More than,
Did I win? I grew my net worth by $120,000. The moment she makes $5,000, my net worth will be $240,000 just in this business.
Yep.
The moment she does $10,000 per month, my net worth will be $480,000 in this business. Make sense? The business will be worth $2.4 million. And the investors win. Every year they get their dividends. Will they win? They win.
Yep.
Do the kids win? They win as well, right?
More people,
so that means I created value for all four parties, you know. Everyone wins, no one loses it. And I always believe, right, that value can be created just like that. A lot of people feel, for me to win means you have to lose. For you to win means I have to lose. If I win means you lose, right?
Mm.
But I don't think that way. I think that overall, everyone can win together, right? Right now, humanity is a lot healthier than we were before. We are living longer. There's more of us, okay? And let's say if you have a mobile phone right now, if you have an iPhone right now, right, you are living a life better than a king in 1600s or 1700s. Yep. True?
Mm.
You have more access to everything than they have.
For sure, okay? Yeah.
So I think that humanity as a collective can win together. I think that value can be created. You know, it doesn't mean like, okay, if I sell you this, that means I lose this, you get this, that kind of stuff.
Mm.
Yeah. So I think it doesn't require money to start a business, right? So okay, yesterday I just acquired a new business. Okay, I acquired a quit smoking business to teach people how to quit smoking. Okay, so I partnered with this lady.
Yeah.
So she also sold me 20% of her company for $1, right? Tomorrow we're gonna raise funds. We're gonna sell this at $7,000 for 1%. So should we, yeah, same. It just reads and repeat the same thing, right?
Yeah.
So a lot of people know me only as a Facebook marketing coach, which is what I like to position myself as, right? Because,
yeah.
And I would say I was quite lucky that I was able to get 1,000 members quite fast. Yeah. Maybe because they, okay, like, I don't know. I right now when I try to reverse engineer, I don't know how I managed to get 1,000 members. It's like just people just keep promoting for me, and then they keep promoting. Yeah. I just keep speaking, they keep promoting, I keep speaking. Mm. And because my closing rate is quite high, so I'm able to get 1,000 paid members. Each one will pay from $500 to $1,997. Yeah, 1,000 people will pay $500 to $1,997 to attend my courses and everything. And I think just now you asked me a good question. Okay, like just now before this call, you were asking me something about Master Implementer or something. Yeah, can you elaborate a bit more than that? Then maybe I share my thoughts about that.
Sure, but first, like, wow, I think the things you share is so freaking open, right? I think those is damn freaking powerful. Like, that's just something you're just damn open you're sharing. But so I'm going to go do that, right? But so Master Mentor, basically, I'm sure if you're thousands of students, there are some people with like amazing results. They get like freaking like powerful results. But at the same time, there are some that might be still stuck or still not at the level where it is. What do you think are the difference in the characteristics or the traits, right, of the students who are actually achieving way better and faster results than the rest of your students, for example?
I'll share from two perspectives. First, and I'll share a perspective of myself as a student because I've attended a lot of courses as well. I spent over $90,000 of my own money investing courses. Like recently, I paid $30K to like Richard Tan for course and all that, right? And then last time, I paid $13K for mentorship, and I paid a lot of money for courses here and there. Okay, so I share from a perspective of a coach and a perspective of a student. Okay, so for me, I'm a Facebook coach, right? And there are so many times, right, to be honest, that I want to quit this business because coaching, right, is the most closely related to being a scammer. You know, you do a coaching business, right, you can sell someone a $7 book, and they can complain and call you a scammer, you know. I can see people, they complain about Dean Graziosi, complain about Tony Robbins. They just bought a $7 book, and they can complain, and that kind of thing, right? Because coaching is the most related to being a scammer. Why? Because there's no product or service. The product, right, the service, right, is not our time. The service is not an online course. The service is not information. The product that we are selling, right, is a better version of you.
Mm.
Make sense? Yeah. The better version of the customer.
Yeah.
So it's like when people buy a course, they're not buying my time, they're not buying my coaching, they're not buying my support, everything. They're buying a better version of themselves.
Yep.
They're buying a version of themselves that knows Facebook marketing. They're buying a version of themselves that knows real estate investing, right? Yeah. So I've trained over 1,000 students, and so everyone goes through the same system, you know, but how come everyone turn out differently? It's because the client is the variable. The client is the variable. Mm. Okay. But as a coach, I told myself, okay, if I do quit coaching, the next person who takes my place will probably not do a better job than me. So I told myself, okay, I must continue doing coaching. Okay.
Okay.
Like for example, for me, for my own clients, right, I add them my WhatsApp group. I don't add them to a Facebook group, you know. I add them to a WhatsApp group. That means they have my personal number, everything, and WhatsApp is super responsive, and I reply to every single question that they have. Okay. I do coaching calls once every 2 weeks. So like once a week or once every 2 weeks. So every 2 weeks I do a Zoom call or I do a group. Like before the virus, I was doing in the classroom style and everything. Everything I had to pay for classroom, rent a classroom and everything, conduct my coaching sessions, right? Sometimes I do a 2-day course or 1-day course. So I really ask myself, I really give them everything I can give them already. Okay, I don't just give them knowledge, you know, I give them the skill sets. And sometimes in my course, right, I give them leads also, you know. That means I give them a list of 20 Telegram groups. Each Telegram group got 10,000 leads to prospect. All they have to do is just join the group and send out their marketing message and everything, they'll get results, you know. And on top of that, I still give them opportunities. That means I give them, I say, okay, you join my course, right? Number one, you can market my course. Number two, I partner with a spa. Okay, I partner with a spa, you can market the spa and make money. You can partner with this tuition business, make money. I give them so many opportunities to market, right? So I give them my connections as well, which means, for example, okay, recently I work with Terence Chow. Terence Chow Po Hui. Chow Po Hui is a MediaCorp celebrity. So I told him to become a coach because I told him, hey, you're already 50 plus. You cannot be an actor for the rest of your life. You might as well be a coach.
Yeah.
How to become an actor, right? So he launched his course, you know. So I asked all my students to go for his course because I want them to get close to Terence Chow. Why? Because if they can get close to Terence Chow, they get a whole new network of all the celebrities and the and all the kind of stuff, right? So I told myself, I try. I try to help give them everything ready, you know, right? And okay, right now I'm reaching a phase in my life, right, where I can help anyone to make $10,000 or $20,000 a month, but I cannot help everyone to make $10,000 or $20,000 a month.
You can help anyone, but not everyone, right?
Yeah. Which, like, for example, recently I promoted for a lady, right? In 20 minutes, I helped her make $14,000. She sold a $700 course. I sold 20 out of 30 people who bought a $700 course. She made $14,000 in 20 minutes, right? Mm. And I sell for her, right? So there's nothing she has to do on her part and everything. So I can help anyone, but can I keep duplicating the same process again and again? I cannot, because I only have a certain amount of leads. I only have a certain amount of resources. Yeah. Right. Okay. So I told myself, okay, at the end of the day, coaching is only 20% of a client's success, yep. And the other 80%, right, is up to them. And the moment I came to terms with that fact, right, and I agree and accept that, okay, I'm only 20% of their success, and that's why everyone who succeeds, I've got clients who make 100K a month. Okay, I've got clients who make let's say 1 week after my course, they sell property. They make $80,000 in commissions in a week. Okay, yep. I've got clients 10 months after the course, then they got their first result. But on their 10th month, they make $50,000 a month selling property. Mm. I've got a client 20 years old. Okay, he's one of my students, Leonard Peng. He made $46,000 in December. How he do it? He sell a coaching package to teach people how to run a social media marketing agency. $5,700 per person. He sold 8 people. He made $46,000 in 1 month. Okay, I've got clients like Joel Chin. 21 years old, okay? Studying medicine school. On the side, he does digital marketing. On the side, you know, he made $20,000 last month. Okay, every month he makes about 5 figures, most like easily. Okay, his first 12 months doing digital marketing, he made 150K already. Okay, so but I told myself, I'm only 20% of that success. I wasn't 100% of that success.
Yep.
I was only 20% of that success. And the moment I came to terms with that, and when people don't succeed, I told myself, okay, I'm only 20% of that. The other 80% was them. I already give them the skill sets that they need. I give them the systems that they need, the processes that they need. I give them the leads that they need. I give them the opportunities that they need. But 80% still belongs to them. And I cannot take responsibility for them. Because if I did, it'll make me a very, very miserable person. It'll make me a very egoistic person. If I took 100% of their success, it'll make me a very egoistic person. If I took 100% of their failure, it'll make me a very miserable. It's like I cannot blame myself for it raining out there, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Within my locus of control, right? So I told myself, so long as out of this 20%, I do 100% of what I can. I have 100% intention to do whatever I can, right? And give all the coaching calls and make sure, like every single day I give them new content, you know. Recently I recorded coaching calls, right? That of me closing clients over the phone. So I will upload it and I'll break down what went well, what could be improved, why this call closed, why this call didn't close. I make sure I give them every single, even like, let's say, whatever I shared with you about capital mechanism. You know, I paid $11,000 for a 3-day course to learn capital mechanism. Whatever I shared with you in 10 minutes, right? Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, if you really want to implement it, honestly, then you could find, whatever you found, whatever you learned in 20 minutes, right? It could make you $100,000. You could find someone that's willing to partner with you for 20%, and you implemented and you raise funds, right? You will make $120,000. Yeah. So I think it's about that. Like, yeah. It's about the client. At the end of the day.
Yeah. So that's from the coach perspective. I think that's a very powerful mindset, especially for people who are like you said, like upcoming coaches, upcoming trainers, right? So they don't take the response like I'm not 100%, right? So then from the students' portion, right? What do you think are some of the traits or things that for people, like, I want to start, but I'm still a bit afraid, or like how do I get myself unstuck and be one of your like success stories, for example?
Okay. From a student's perspective, I would say you need to stay as close to the campfire as possible, which means if let's say the group is engaging, right? So like the coach cannot reach out to you one-on-one. I cannot go and reach out to every 1,000 of my students, right? Every time I do a Zoom call, maybe about 50 people come on a Zoom call, the maximum is maybe 100 people, or 1,000 people, 10%, 5%, right? So I keep doing these Zoom calls, I'm creating this campfire, right? But I cannot reach out to them and say, hey, come to the Zoom call. So I think as a student, what we need to do is just keep sticking close to the campfire. I would say almost every client, right, that has been for at least more than 5 Zoom calls, right, they should at least make some money, one. Few thousand dollars, at least sure, one. But to make $1,000 is really easy, okay? Yeah. So, you just sell a few things, you make $1,000, right? So, I would say stay close to the campfire. And number two is, before you sign up for a course, you just need to make an accurate decision and say, okay, do you think that this coach will be of value to you? Do you think you can learn something from this guy? If you feel that you can learn something from this guy, then by all means, just go for it. Because there's nothing to lose. Yeah.
Yeah.
And stay close to the campfire and then take action. Okay. So I always say there's four pillars of success. Mentorship, enrichment, network, and action. Okay. So number one, you must get the right mentor. Get someone who's way ahead of you, mentor. Enrichment. Enrichment means like reading books, success audios, online courses, seminars. Reading, you must go for more of this, right? I spent over 90K on enrichment. And you must have network. Because you see, a lot of times why people don't succeed, right? It's because of the people that they are surrounded with. If they surround themselves with more positive people, they'll succeed naturally. Like, if let's say, okay, every day I talk to you and I'm talking about how I'm buying businesses at $1 and making $120,000 in 3 days. After I keep talking to you every single day about this, you're like, I tell you, within 1 month, right, you'll start buying your first business, really. You get what I mean? And then you keep going that on and on and on. And then the last thing is action, taking massive action. So just implementing whatever you learn from your mentor and all the kind of stuff. So I think these are four things. And these four principles of success apply in every area of life. Whether you play pool. So I'm like, I'm a national youth pool player, right? So I play pool, I'm a mentor, I'm a pool coach, national youth pool coach. I took a lot of enrichment. I watched a lot of YouTube videos about pool and everything. I took, I networked with all the other national youth pool players. And I realized when I play good players, I become better. I play lousy players, my game drops. Why? Because I slack and everything, right? And number four, I took massive action. And these four principles of success apply in every single thing. Pool, basketball, soccer, marketing, sales,
dance, anything.
The relationships, right? If all your friends are damn good with their relationship and are very good husbands and wives, you become a good husband and wife as well. If they're all players, you become a player as well. It's just how it is, yeah. So I hope that's of value to all of you. I hope you all wrote some notes on that. Yeah.
So much value, right? So thanks, Eric, right? So I just have one last question before close our interview, right? So like right now, right, is the whole like COVID situation and all, like what are some of like, maybe like one or two biggest tips for like aspiring or current entrepreneurs or business people right now that you could give to them, right, as a way to close off the interview?
Okay, great. So, okay. Different people have different thoughts about how they should play in this interview, in this situation. There are some marketers who tell you, oh, this is the time you need to go all in, you need to go all in and all in, right? And there are some that say, okay, like for me, right now, my play is basically, in this situation, I've been a lot more quiet in this situation, and my play is, my game plan is to recollect, right? Figure out different businesses and everything, like fine-tune all the leaks in my businesses so that when the virus does finish, I will whack the market hard again. Because I mean, I could go against the gradient and say, okay, I still want to do seminars, I just limit to, okay, I've got a legal restriction, which is 10 people per seminar, right?
Yeah.
So I could say, okay, I don't care about the thing, I just do 8 people per seminar and just keep going hard. You see, when you do business, we got to go with the trend, right? So like, if I really know that, okay, I cannot continue doing seminars, then I gotta pivot. I gotta pivot and find something else, right? So I think now is the best time to contract your business. And sometimes the best growth comes from contracting. Because when you contract, you see, perfection, right? It's not when there's nothing more to add on. Perfection, right, is when there's nothing more to take away. Perfection is not when there's nothing more to add on. Perfection is when there's nothing more to take away. So let's say a team, right? Now is the best time to shrink your team. Because you need to shrink all the C players, get them, kick them out. Use this excuse excuse to kick them out. So that you only be left with the A players. Make sense?
Optimal,
Perfection is not when you have more employees and wasted, you know, you're wasting resources. You just need to, you need to trim all the fats in your business, every single place that you feel that, I've been spending on this expense, it's not even making money. I've been spending on this entertainment expense, not making money. I've been spending on this travel expense, not making money. This is the time to cut down on all those things. And I think this is the best time to learn new stuff, right? Then I saw this quote on Instagram, it say, if after this whole COVID virus, right, you didn't learn a new skill or start a new side hustle, it was never a lack of time. You never had a lack of time. You just had a lack of discipline. Yeah.
Yep,
if you had more discipline, right? This is not the perfect time to learn and upskill. So that's the same thing that I'm doing. And so I'm contracting, but at the same time I'm buying businesses, right? Which means all these businesses I don't cash out now, you know. Means like, okay, my net worth increased by 180K, right? But I still own 20% of the shares in the company. I won't sell my shares until after the virus. Everything must follow trends, right? After the virus, people got more money already. I raise funds while there's this virus, but I don't sell my shares because now I sell the shares 1% for 6K. Next time I can sell 1% for 12K. Why I sell 1% for 6K for? So I think I'm taking a different approach from a lot of the marketers out there who are talking about growing bigger. But at the same time, I'm pivoting as well, which means I'm doing online webinars instead. So on Sunday will be my first webinar. Like today is Friday, right? So on Sunday will be my first webinar. So I'm going to do online webinars. I'm going to go quite loud on online webinars because I cannot be like my coaching business completely dropped because of seminars. So we are expecting quite a number of people on the webinar.
Yeah, nice. And
it's my first time doing webinars. It's my first time trying this skill set, and hopefully it works. I'm not sure how it's going to turn out. But it's the best time to pick up a new skill set. So I told myself, last time all the while I wanted to do webinars. Just like I told myself, if I do a seminar and I do a webinar, I might as well do a seminar. Why the hell would I do a webinar instead? Yeah. But now I'm forced to do a webinar. So I'm forced to evolve. I'm forced to
It's a new grow. Experience, man. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a new experience.
Yeah, hey, thanks. Yeah. Thanks so much, Elroy. Right, so I think those are really good sharing, right? So for my audience wants to find you, how can they find you, man?
You can search me on Google, Elric Ong, A-L-A-R-I-C space O-N-G.
You put the link.
My website is www.elricong.com. And then my Facebook is Elric Ong. Instagram, A-L-A-R-I-C-O-N-G-G, two Gs. Yeah.
Okay.
So, O-N-G-G. That's where you can find me.
You put the links below.
And for Mark, same thing. Where can they find you?
Yeah, so I'm very, very active on Facebook, Mark Teo, MARC.TOO. We'll put the links down and everything, but I think that's my main platform right now. So you can check me out on Facebook.
Anyway, keep on inspiring. I think the work you're doing on Telegram, everything is amazing, right?
Thank you.
I think it can help grow Singapore as a collective. Like the only thing that's gonna bring us out of a recession or depression is when all of us learn marketing well. Because when all of us get better at marketing, there are more sales transactions happening in the economy.
Sure.
More value can be created. When more value is created, the whole economy as a collective will rise. More jobs are created. More people can spend. And then it grows that way. So we need more people like you. We need more people like myself.
Too,
to grow Singapore, help them with marketing. Yeah. And I think that's how we create more value. Let's create a world where everyone wins, all right?
Yeah. Awesome, man. All right.
See you.
Thanks, Aaron. Thanks, everyone.
All right.
See you all.
Take care.
Bye.
See you. Bye-bye.